sing. Come on there. I've already been stirring, so I may as well stir some more. We're glad that you're here tonight. We hope you come with your cup right side up, and let's just have a good time in the Lord.
Thank you. since we sung that one out. It's a good one. It's a good one. Page 9. Above all names.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. Turn to page 31. This is a request of Miss Betty, and me and her, sometimes we find we're on the same wavelength.
Oh,
Amen. We have that privilege of calling Him our Lord. He died and shed His blood for us. But the angel called Him Jesus, Lord of the Virgin. Mary called Him Jesus, but I called Him. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. You all just put the books on the cart. Thank you. Go down.
Let's have a good old-fashioned handshake while they're getting these books put out. Request tonight before we pray. I think they're still socializing. Let's keep Jumbo Bias in our prayers. And I know that we have shut-ins that they need our prayers. And we need one another's prayers, don't we? So we've all always got something to pray about. Anyone else tonight before we go to the Lord in prayer?
My nephew, he just lost his wife Thursday morning. He's in the hospital, so we're having him for a longer service for her. He's got double pneumonia.
Gracious sakes.
My sister down in Florida really needs some prayer.
Yeah. John's got a sister that's in stage 4 cancer, so let's remember her tonight. Anyone else? Amen. Good, good. I'm sure all of us. Two sisters?
Okay.
Okay. Oh, goodness. Yeah, bless their heart. We'll be praying.
They got an earthquake this morning over there, and pretty heavy earthquake. I don't know how much damage it did.
remember this tonight. Just remember this. And fella.
I prayed for Patricia. She told me today, she said she don't feel like celebrating Christmas. But I told her, I said, you got them two precious babies. I said, you got to be there for the baby. So
yeah.
Her husband's trying to leave or something. Just pray for Patricia and the babies.
Just remember this tonight. Fellow that worked with Michael at Rieger, Ben Brown, he passed away, I think, yesterday. And let's remember Sister Brown and that family this evening. Anyone else?
Brother Roberts, he's going to Cleveland County tomorrow. He's going to test himself, so pray
the man turn up. Amen. Amen. Anyone else? Got a lot to pray about, don't we? And I'm sure everybody has someone. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. You lead out tonight as the Lord would lead you. We pray this song.
Precious Father, Amen. And Lord, we're glad, Lord God, that we can come just as we are. We call some time that the Father had had the great well in the morning and left out on the kind of meditation with the cause of the mighty grace and the love. The grace, Heavenly Father, that sets the captive free. The grace that gives us hope and victory, Heavenly Father. We give you praise tonight. And we thank you, Heavenly Father, for the blood that's been applied for the victory, Lord, that you have tonight over your leaders. And because you made them and have you there, God, in our life, we pray, Holy Spirit, tonight, walk the aisles, the avenues of our hearts tonight. Lord God, may we go away from this place refreshed and have knowing, Lord God, we've been in the mighty presence of the living God. I thank you, Lord, of the many that are sick and afflicted. Others, Lord God, that are going to be traveling. And Lord, others tonight, Heavenly Father, that are mourning the loss of love. Lord, we pray the precious Spirit of the living God tonight that you have your precious right to live. Oh God, with every song that's sung, with every testimony that's given, with every shout of praise, may Heavenly Father, you be glorified and magnified. We pray, Heavenly Father, have your praises by the way. And Lord God, for all things you do, give strength to the name of Jesus. Lord, the sugar has been,
we're going to wait upon you for the evening offering. Charlie, since you've already got money in your plate, you just ask the Lord's blessing upon that offering this evening.
Father, again, we thank you, Lord, for your wonderful blessing, for your love and mercy, your grace, and your long-suffering to us, Lord. We appreciate what you do for us. And we ask for this evening, again, that you will bless this offering and sanctify for the building of your kingdom. And I glorify you and honor you in all.
Amen. Amen. Now you give tonight as the Lord's given to you. Thank you. Thank you for that evening offering. Make a few announcements. Keep in mind that this Thursday evening, 6:30, will probably be the last rehearsal for the choir before the cantata next Sunday. And then next Sunday morning, the Christmas cantata will be presented during the morning service. And during the evening service, the youth will have their presentation. So be much in prayer for both of those. We'll have a Singspiration on Sunday, September 29th, during the evening service. My goodness, everything that I mentioned has to do with singing. And this one, even with this one, make plans to be with us on Tuesday, December 31st, for the New Year's Eve service beginning at 7 p.m. The J. Humphreys Trio and Covered by Love will be here to sing. And a great big thanks is extended to Julie Barr for preparing the new church directory. And said we appreciate you, Julia. Thank you all so much for the Thanksgiving offering of $800 for World of, for Christ Missions. And that comes from Wanda and Lavana. And keep in mind that in the back of the church there, that there's a box for Christmas cards for those that want to bring our church family a Christmas card. And make sure that when you leave here next Sunday evening or by next Sunday evening that you check that thing and take those cards with you. Steve every year has several that he has to end up, thrown away. And just check that box next Sunday evening. And I think that's all of our announcements. I will say a hearty welcome to Roger Price and his and Mrs. Price that are here with us tonight. And I always tell everyone, if you don't mind the Lord, it's your own fault. And of course, we're glad for all of you that are here tonight. We hope you've come out with your cup right side up and you're saying, "Fill me, Lord, fill me." Who we got up there is going to sing for us tonight? Got Robin, maybe somebody get under conviction while she's coming and get that tape, CD to you.
The Lord is not too busy that He can't reach down and mend a broken heart. And my burden is not too heavy that He can't hear a plea of faith. God still answers prayer. God still answers prayer. In His time, He'll work a miracle. He will never fail. Satan has lost. lost the battle, when to the Lord you humbly bow. God still answers prayer. If you feel that life is hopeless and the night has no end, there's hope for your hurting heart. For he will be there with you no matter what you're going through. God still answers prayer. God still answers prayer. In his time, he'll work a miracle. He will never fail. Satan has lost the battle, when to the Lord you humbly bow. God still answers prayer. Satan has lost the battle, when to the Lord you humbly bow. God still answers prayer.
That's it. Trio, are you going to sing tonight?
Here
you
go.
Oh. Do you think that's what it is?
All that?
Yeah,
Paul Anthony used to say.
Oh, I'd love to hear you call that.
Come on, honey. You're great.
I didn't say anything, Paul. That I asked you beforehand, but I didn't say anything.
It was me
and
me,
she wasn't even looking at me. I'm sitting over here hollering her name, and she's
going to do that. Somebody get that CD for her, and while she's coming up. And I tell you what we can do, somebody can testify. If you feel like giving the God the praise and the glory, go right ahead while she's coming up.
Praise His holy name!
Amen!
Yeah, good. Good.
Well, I guess I'll do that. I am so thankful. He's so good to me and my family. He keeps us on the go, and he keeps me out there going. But I'll tell you what, I love every town I'm here. I'm crazy. I love him with nothing.
Gonna need someone to see me through. When I'm alone and full of doubt, I'll be looking for a believer to pull me out. I need a spirit-filled, iron-willed, heaven-blessed pastor test saint to remind me that I'm a straight running, overcoming, saved by grace, child of faith. I need to know, is there a Christian in the house, one to lend a hand? Is there a Christian in the house, come on and take a stand? Well, I don't need a doctor when my hope is running out. Somebody tell me, is there a Christian in the house? There are days that Pam's a mess. I'm gonna need someone to help ease the stress. There are nights full of tears when I'm praying for an angel to appear. Don't need a stone throwing undertow and criticizing, analyzing, judge to deflate me. I want a life-giving, gospel-driven, gentle, ever-loving nudge. I need to know, is there a Christian in the house? Come on and take a stand. Is there a Christian in the house? Come on and take a stand. Well, I don't need a doctor when my hope is running out. Somebody tell me, is there a Christian in the house? Christians do I have in the house tonight? Amen. I need a spirit-filled, iron-willed, heaven-blessed, pass-the-test saint to remind me that I'm a straight-running, overcoming, saved by grace, child of faith. Faith. Know, is there a Christian in the house? Come on and lend a hand. Is there a Christian in the house? Come on and take a stand. Well, I don't need a doctor when my hope is running out. Somebody tell me, is there a Christian in the house? Oh, somebody tell me, is there a Christian in the house? Is there a Christian in this house?
Come on, Charlie.
Don't get that.
What are we singing?
First one we sang together.
Is that okay?
Yeah.
For many long years in bondage, God's chosen people had been out in the wilderness wandering, was all because of sin. Their leader had been old Moses, but now that he had died, God said to Joshua, get on the other side. Cross over to the other side of Jordan. The Lord to Joshua said, cross over to the other side of Jordan. My people must be led no longer in the wilderness wandering. From Egypt's bondage flee. And when you reach the other side, you shall be free. The river now lies before you, and all the waters control. Now is the time to cross over, the waters back will roll. A wonderful land is waiting just over Jordan's tide. Remember, victory is on the other side. Cross over to the other side of Jordan. The Lord to Joshua said, cross over to the other side of Jordan. My people must be led no longer in a wilderness wandering. From Egypt's bondage flee. And when you reach the other side, you shall be free.
All right. I don't guess Mike's got anything else up there tonight. Okay. Is everybody minded the Lord? All hearts free tonight?
If you have your Bibles, turn with me to 2 Timothy tonight. I think I'll start at verse 6. It's all scripture's good, but let's start there at verse 6. First chapter, 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 6. Wherefore, I put thee to remembrance that thou stir up the gift of God, which is in you, thee, by the putting on of my hands. For God hath not given us the spirit of fear, but of power, and of love, and of a sound mind. Be not thou therefore ashamed of the testimony of our Lord, nor of me his prisoner, but be thou a partaker of the affliction of the gospel according to the power of God, who hath saved us and called us with a holy calling, not according to our works, but according to his own purpose and grace, which was given us by Christ Jesus before the world began. And you can read the rest of that tonight. Would you bow your heads with us for a word of prayer? Now, our Heavenly Father, Lord, we're glad that we've crossed over. And Lord, we're no longer in bondage, the bondage of sin tonight, but that, Lord, we've been given a hope, thank God, that goes beyond this veil of tears. And Heavenly Father, we've said many a times, and Lord, I think sometimes we can say it so much that people don't realize that every time that we say it, Lord, we mean it. We need your help. We know that, Heavenly Father, if there's anything accomplished here this evening, it'll be because of God's mighty grace and power. And I pray, Heavenly Father, that you'd put your thumb in our back. Give us that unction and that anointing of God's Holy Spirit that makes an ordinary man a preacher of the Word of God, and that you'd use us, Heavenly Father, that when our people leave here tonight, that, Lord, they might have a skip in their step. The joy bells might be ringing in their heart, and they might be able to say that the house of God is a good place to be. Now use us tonight, our Father, and Lord, we'll give you the praise and the glory. For it's in Jesus' name that we ask these things, and amen. By the way, if someone's missing a set of sunglasses, they were out on the parking lot. Whoever parked close to Julie may have lost their sunglasses, so keep that in mind. I thought this evening, the Lord kind of directed me in a path of speaking to you and I, being a Christian people. I thought, it seems like that, my friends, that is a long time between a revival meeting to a revival meeting, and somehow along the way, God's people, I need every once in a while to get a stirring within their soul. And we can't always depend on things
happening, a service come like we have so many times, where there doesn't have to be any preaching, and the Spirit of the Lord just goes from heart to heart and warms us strangely by His Spirit. And I begin to look tonight, and I saw Timothy. As Paul was talking to him about the gift that he had been given, and stirring up that gift, and I began to look at about the word stirring there, and it has the thought of a person that has a fire, and that fire is beginning to dwell a little bit, and maybe the embers they're needing just a little bit of stirring up, and there needs to be some fuel put to the fire, that the fire could burn oh so brightly and would have the glow that the people needed. I thought, my friends, tonight concerning this, that he said to stir up that gift that is within you, old Timothy. I thought of this, that you and I, my friends, if we are going to have a gift that God has given, it must be used. If God gives us something, it may be that, my friend, God's given you a voice, and maybe the gift of teaching. But if you never use it, my friends, it's going to go by the wayside. We've often spoke and heard of individuals that, my friend, had the gift to be able to sing. And we've heard people say, if you don't use it, you'll lose it. And so probably that it is. But I thought tonight concerning the gift of God that was given to you and I, of how that, my friend, He so miraculously came into our heart one day, sin went one way, and we went in a new direction, walking in the light of God and having power in His Spirit. I'll tell you something tonight. You don't just stand, my friend, when these things occur. What happens? If my friends, if we're going to stay active, my friend, we're going to have the blessings of God, which He gives us. I thought he lit a fire in my soul that night when I bowed at that altar up there at the Jackson Avenue Church. And my friend, I got up. I was stirred and refreshed. And I was free and cleansed. And the knowing that, my friends, that old things had passed away. Amen. And that all things had become new, and I was a new creation walking in the light of God. But I thought, my friends, along the way, there had to be some things take place. If I was to stay, my friend, with the fire burning, and I remember there was a little lady out there at the Jackson Avenue Church, Grace Merle was her name, and she, at the time that I was saved, she was elderly. My friend, she couldn't get up, so to speak. But as she sat there beside that piano that day, she said, "Roger," she said, "I want to tell you something." She said, "If you ever see that you're beginning to, the coals of fire are beginning to lose their glow, and you're beginning to become cool in the things of God, then fan the flames of the fire till the fire don't burn." And I thought, I've learned a lot over the years that you and I, as the people of God, must stay stirred, and we can't depend upon someone else's, my friend, pushing us along. I heard something, Sue, I said that God, can He, what was the word you used, Sue? Can He prod you along? Sometimes God will do that, but my friend, He expects you and I, my friend, to take to have the intestinal fortitude that say, sink, swim, survive, or perish. No matter what others do, I'm going to serve the Lord. And my friend, be willing to stand fast and know that He's God, and beside He, that
that there is none other, and walk in the light of God. And so let our light shine before this world, that they can see our good works and glorify our Father which is in heaven. I began to think this evening, as I sit there, how can I get a message across? I know that in the last revival, we had some folk to get saved. And my friends, you can't depend upon having that good feeling and feeling the fervor, my friend, until the next revival comes. Matter of fact, I'll tell you what, there's an enemy there that from the very beginning, he's going to do his best to try to discourage you and get you, my friend, off focus. Certainly, our focus is upon him. And if we get our focus off of him, the enemy can begin to work upon us and cause us, my friend, problems along the way. I believe the first thing that he does, he tries to point a people out to you. Maybe it's someone, my friend, that isn't doing exactly what that they should. But my friend, the devil, he'll point out to you, and you know what he'll say? He'll say, now look at them, and they call themselves a Christian. That's why that it's important that you and I, as Christian people, so live our lives that, my friend, they can find no fault in the things of God. And I tell you what, I'm glad, thank God, that I know, my friend, one who can. Many a times along the way, I've become discouraged. And I thought, well, how in the world that I'm going to make it? And then I looked up and seen that there was a great and merciful God in heaven that's taken me through up to the point that I believe by the help of the grace of God, he'll carry us through until that day that he says, enter in thou good faithful servant. You've been faithful in a few things. Going to make you ruler over many. But I thought, it's up to us as Christian people, my friend, to keep the fire stirred. And I'm speaking not only, my friend, to the younger Christian tonight. I'm speaking to those of us that have been in the way for many a years. You don't get too old, my friend, for the devil to want you to just sit down by the wayside and kind of take it easy. I remember someone saying one time, well, I was active when I was young. Now that I'm older, I'm going to sit down beside the wayside and let some of the younger folk take care of it. That's not the way it ends. My friend, we got to run this race until the day that he takes us home. And it'll be good for you and I as the people of God to realize there's a work for every one of us to do. And God's given us a gift and a calling. I thought of Timothy. I believe that what Paul was saying, we laid hands upon you and we put you were called to the ministry. Now what you need to do is to take that gift and go with it and make it certainly fruitful for the kingdom and the glory of God. I know that tonight that you and I as God's people, we need every once in a while, as Sue said, to be kind of prodded along. But in the midst of it, we have to be strong in the Lord and take courage, my friends, in the fact that he's going to go before us, my friend, and open those doors many a times that seem to be closed before us. And I thought, how do we keep the fire burning within our soul? First of all, I believe that it is on a daily basis. We don't wait a week. They said, someone said 7 days without prayer makes 1 week. And my friend, I'll tell you what, it'll certainly weaken you. But you and I, as the people of God, I thought I heard someone say just a few days ago about how that they get up in the morning and they turn the music on and things begin to happen and God begins to bless. Well, that's a part of it. If it can be done with music, that's good. It's the words of the song that causes our heart to be stirred. But there's more to it than that. No, he said men ought always to pray and not to faint. I believe that, my friends, that God gives us that of a prayer life. And I'll tell you what, a lot of people say that they don't pray because they don't know how to pray. But I'll tell you what they can do. They can go into a group of
and kind of talk until my friend, they wear them all out. So why couldn't we have my friend had that conversation with God? Get alone with him and say, it's me again, Lord. I'm in need of prayer and allowing my friend to stir our hearts. And my friend calls us, my friend, to fan the flames of the fire till the fire don't burn. They used to sing a song, 'tis burning in my soul, 'tis burning in my soul. The fire of heavenly love, it's burning in my soul. I'll tell you what, this evening, if you want to have things to go like a church should, I don't want to get the people to ever say that this church is a dead church set beside the road, and it will not be as long as God's people take the time on a daily basis to cause themselves to be stirred, and my friends, add fuel to the fire. The fuel is in the Word of God. The fuel is in your prayer life. The fuel is in testifying and giving God the glory and being obedient. When God says go, you go, and when he tells you to say, you say. That's what brings the blessing upon you and causes your heart to be filled and thrilled with the precious Spirit of God. I pray that somehow tonight that I can say something that'll cause us as the people of God to fan that flame and cause the fire to burn, to where the glow that comes off of that fire will cause someone else to think, and my friend want to have just a little bit of what we got way down deep in her soul. Oh, thank God. I'm glad tonight for Jesus and what Jesus has done and what Jesus is doing right now.
Amen.
I thought, my friend, you and I, as the people of God, need to keep that fire burning within our soul. And then I thought this evening, I had a fellow, I was at the VA hospital the other day, and we were talking on the way out of the elevator, and I'd said something about it being a little bit cool. And he said to me, well, I'm not going to worry too much about it. I've got a fellow, I guess he used bottle gas, and he said, I've got a fellow coming. He said, I've got two big tanks, and he's going to fill those tanks with fuel. I'll have plenty of fuel for the fire. We don't wait until the fire gets down before we go to the bottle gas man. We get it done, Paul, that my friend, we still got fire, and then we've got plenty of fire to burn. I caught my friend of how that many times people, they'll wait till, my friend, they're running on fumes, and then my friend wonder if they're going to get to the gas station, my friend, going on those fumes. I wonder this evening how many people are running on fumes. You've had the opportunities, and God has blessed you in so many ways, and my friend, you've just been kind of diligent in what you need to do. It's time to fan the flame and get the fire up burning.
Amen.
When we come into the house of God, that things happen and people are touched and blessed, and they'll go away from this place saying, the house of God has been a good place to be.
Yes. Amen.
It's up to us to making sure that we stir up, that we fan, that we cause the fire. I'm not a builder of a fire. As a matter of fact, Mike, he has a wood burner out there in his garage, and I thought all he had to do is just fill it full of wood and take a piece of paper and light it, and you'd have a fire, but it don't work that way. And the first thing I found out is the damper was closed. If you don't get a little air, you ain't gonna have no fire. And then I have found out sometimes that wet wood will cause a fire to burn. I'm just an old dumb boy, and I wasn't from the country, so I don't know too much about a fire. But I found out shortly after I was saved how to keep the fire burning.
Amen.
Being faithful.
Amen.
giving him the praise and the glory.
Yes.
Living every day as if it were my last day.
Yeah.
We don't know when that day or that time is going to come. So let's fan that flame and that fire and allow our souls to be filled and to be thrilled with the precious presence of God. It'll do something about all of those
Amen.
That are round about us.
That's right.
You'd be surprised what a little fire will do.
Amen.
They'll be attracted to you. Our precious Heavenly Father, we thank you tonight for your mighty grace and power. And Lord, we thank you for the privilege that we have tonight for prayer. And we ask you, our Father, to bless our people. And Lord, to help them to realize, Lord, that you don't have to wait till you're running on fumes to light the fire. May the fire of our soul be lit, and may, Lord God, it be seen, your presence be seen in our midst. We give you praise and glory. In Jesus' name, and amen. Shake hands.